In an unprecedented move, North Korea has sent letters to the parliaments of several countries asking that they unite against the Trump administration. The move comes as North Korea accuses the U.S. of trying to start a nuclear war and warns that it will retaliate. Meanwhile, President Trump's national security advisor, General H.R. McMaster, says the U.S. is running out of time to resolve this peacefully.
The president's been extremely clear on his perspective on North Korea. He is not going to accept this regime threatening the United States with a nuclear weapon. He just won't accept it. So there are those who have said, well, you know what? What about accept and deter? Well, accept and deter is unacceptable. And so this puts us in a situation where we are in a race to resolve this short of military action. Everybody knows it.
I want to bring in our CNN political director, David Chalian. He's over here at the Magic Wall. We've got some new polling on how the American public feels about this threat from North Korea and how the American public feels about the way the president, President Trump, has responded.
That's right. Well, if we ask a whole bunch of foreign policy issues and areas, very serious threat to the United States. North Korea, you could see, is way up there. 62% of Americans in this brand new CNN poll conducted by SRS says North Korea is a very serious threat. Everything else is well below that. That has skyrocketed this year as we've seen the rhetoric heat up. We also asked people, is Donald Trump handling the North Korea issue recklessly or responsibly? And take a look at this answer here. 63% of Americans, Wolf, say reckless is how Donald Trump's response has been to North Korea. 32% has said responsible.
What about the Iran nuclear deal? How are the American people responding to that?
They want to stay in the Iran nuclear deal. Take a look at this. 67% of Americans tell us that the U.S. should not withdraw from the Iran nuclear deal. As you know, Donald Trump has said that may be very well where we end up. Only 27% say yes. And take a look at how this breaks out by partisanship. I think this is really instructive because it's across the board here. 80% of Democrats want to remain in the deal. You might expect that. It was a Barack Obama initiative. 67% of independents, 48% of Republicans want to stay in the deal. The Republican Party, the president's own party, is split on this issue, Wolf.
Very interesting numbers indeed, David Chalian. Thank you very, very much. Justin.